What's missing here, what's been missing for a long time, and we're also working on that, has been a business case. Okay, we have to pay for this. The money's got to come from somewhere. Some of it is coming from foundations. Some of it is coming from certain media. But, you know, the argument for so long, investigative journalism costs too much. Well, how many of you knew that the most profitable television show in the history of American networks was CBS's investigative magazine, 60 Minutes? Did you know that? That show was a money maker. The movie The Insider about the tobacco case, there's a scene in there where a CBS executive says to Mike Wallace, the great TV reporter, Mike, and he says, don't you call me Mike, you know, my show keeps your ass in silk. Okay? That's the way it was. He was general office for that network with their investigative stuff. And there are still media out there that are breaking the pattern of decline of the media. Okay, throughout Europe, TV, newspapers are losing audience. They're losing profits. They're downsizing. But the media that have mastered investigation are going against that trend. They are making money. I can give you a number of examples. Is the English magazine The Economist. The Economist is a group that has four different businesses. Every one of those businesses is profitable, and every one of it is based on value-added information that you can't get anywhere else because nobody looked for it. The Canard Enchaîné is a weekly newspaper in France. It carries no advertising. They sell no advertising. Circulation of 500,000 people in a country with 60 million, which means 1% of the population buys the publication every week. They have gross receipts of